Hello YouTube, I'm Nicholas Montez, and you're watching my YouTube channel, The Teenage Movie Critic, and welcome back to my YouTube channel, everybody. I'm so excited to have you all back together again, and in today's video, we're doing a celebration, a cinema review for a film that turned a year old today, which is Past Lives. And this is a movie that I remember seeing about last year in December. I believe it was actually the last movie I ever saw of that year, of my first time watches, and I had a really good... And I was very curious about the film because I saw it on many top 10 lists. And so I'm like, I gotta see this movie. And it didn't quite make it my top 10, but it was definitely my top 20. And I think it still is. I'm not sure. But yeah, this movie definitely did something that I was not expecting with film. And I am glad I finally get to talk about it. So let's go ahead and get started talking about Past Lives. And the first thing we'll talk about with this film is just the story. So if you have no idea what Past Lives is about, it is basically about these two childhood best friends. They grew up in Korea, but one of them, the girl immigrates to New York City to, I guess, get a better life. And obviously they were immigrated there. Well, they were immigrated there because they had to, but also in reality, they want to do that to get a better life and, you know... basically, they're keeping up, but then they kind of separate themselves for a couple years, and then many 30 years have passed, 20 years, they come back together, they hang out a little bit, and basically, that is the point of the movie, as to think of, were they something in a past life? And I think that's what's so beautiful about this movie, is that it tells a story. It's sort of a love story in a way, but a friendship story of this boy and girl who were childhood best friends. You saw the friendship grew, you saw their great moments together, and then one of them had to go away, but they still kept going. They still, you know, were connecting. And then there was a time when they basically wanted to kind of end things because the girl was in America. She was in New York. She can't go to see him because then she'll just waste her opportunities going to see him and she'll miss him. And so it's best to kind of get off of that. And that's kind of what goes through all love stories, is it's going to be hard for both of us if we're separated. Like, we can't do that because that'll be a bad influence. And I personally love the way that this story was told, that it's like, and the girl up to this point in time, when they re-meet, she's already married or she already has a fiance. And that's the big question as to, like, would they be something in a past life? And so it makes that question very interesting. So I really enjoyed the story of this movie. With that said, let's get on to the other great things about this movie. Another great thing about this movie are, of course, the performances. And every performer in this movie are great. Every actor in this movie, they're great. And what I really love about this film is that every performance just feels real. It doesn't really feel like I'm watching a movie. It feels like I'm watching real people. And obviously A24, they do all types of films. And this is possibly the most realist film that I've ever seen from that studio. Tor doesn't feel like I'm watching a movie. And that's so powerful of what performances can do. So I loved I love the performances. Now let's talk about really the emotions here. And with the emotions in this film, it kind of goes back to the acting as well as the greatness of the story. And that when you get to that moment when she has to say goodbye to him and she starts crying, it's like you can understand because they love each other, but in this life, they're not meant for each other. Because we're doing so much different things, and it's kind of it can't work out. And so that's what makes it a little bit heartbreaking at times. But overall, this one was incredible. I do love it. Probably the only thing that I gave it an A minus, and I still do. And it's still a great film, don't get me wrong. It's just sometimes a little boring and a little slow, but at the same time, I still really enjoy it. It's still very great, and overall, I loved it. And that is my review for Past Lives. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.